came to the world you created, trading your crown for a cross. You willingly died, your innocent life paid the cost. Counting your status as nothing, the King of all kings came to serve, washing my feet, covering me with your love. If more of you means less of me, take everything. Yes, all of you is all I need, take everything. You are my life and my treasure. You are my life and my treasure. The one that I can't live without. Here at your feet, my desires and dreams I lay down. Yeah. Oh, here at your feet, my desires and dreams I lay down. If more of you means less of me, so take it. Yes, all of you is all I need, to take everything. If more of you means less to me, to take everything. Yes, all of you is all I need, to take everything. Only you can. Here with my heart in your hands. So Father, I pray, make me more like Jesus. This world is dying to know who you are. You've shown us the way to your. So Father, I pray, make me more like Jesus. Oh Lord, change me like only you can. Here with my heart in your hands. Father, I pray, make me more like Jesus. Dying to know who you are. You've shown us the way to your heart. So Father, I pray, make me more like Jesus. More like Jesus. More like Jesus. Yeah, if more of you means less of me, take everything. Yes, all of you is all I need, take it. Less of me, take everything. guess all you is all I need. Take everything. Amen.
Good morning, church. How's everybody doing today? Glad to see everybody. So if you're new with us and you wanted to get to know more about the church or know about us, the best way to do that is to text ACE Connect to 904-441-6701. Also, while you're there, you can find our digital bulletin there as well. You can just text ACE News to 904-441-6701. We also have the bulletin printed out over on the side there. I'll just hit some of the highlights of things that are coming up. So next week, we're not going to be here. We're going to be over at the Leger's house. Valerie? Okay. I know she's here. So I just don't see her right now. But yeah, Valerie Leger, we're just going to have a pool party. We're going to have hot dogs. We're going to have those sorts of things. So it'll just be a good time of fellowship. And then also next Sunday at 2 o'clock, right here at Southwoods, we're going to do a prayer walk around the school. We do that every year before school starts. So it's a really special time, special moment. So we encourage you to join us here at 2 o'clock for that. Tuesday, August 8th, if you're looking for an opportunity to serve, we have one. That is our annual time to come back to the school here. And we start. We serve hot dogs and chips and drinks to the families of Southwoods as kind of getting started with the school year. So if you're interested in that, come see me or one of the other leaders, and we can kind of get you plugged into all of that. Then the other thing that I want to talk about is Re-Engage. Re-Engage is a special thing in my heart. I think most of you guys know this. You hear me talk about it all the time. I think Martin has a little video he's going to show on it, and let's see.
I came to Re-Engage because, quite frankly, my marriage was in trouble.
We truly felt like our marriage was amazing. We realized that that was not the reality, that we had a good marriage, but that God intended for us to have a great marriage.
The first night I came to Re-Engage, I actually felt positive and hopeful.
I think that 16 weeks is a big commitment, but I think your marriage is worth it.
It was the best 16 weeks that we ever done. Don't regret a thing.
I realized a lot. Initially, it was there are other people just like me. There are other men just like me going through the same problems just like me.
Well, the strongest message that I personally received was that Christ could help if you allowed him in.
Christ was with me all along. I just had to know when and where and how.
There was a lot of stuff in there that we could apply really across the board.
We wanted to get a closer relationship with God. We got a closer relationship in our marriage while we kept God in the center.
We always included Christ in our marriage. He was there, he was visible, we were aware of him, but he wasn't the reason we were in our marriage.
I think we learned that we could work through things more than we thought if given the right tools.
We found out that Re-Engage isn't just for marriages that are suffering or in a difficult spot. It's also for marriages that are thriving, because it's exciting to see what the next level looks like in your marriage, regardless of where you are.
Re-Engage has facilitated even a better marriage.
So much fun. So much more fun than it used to be.
It's one of the best things we've ever done for our marriage. Powerful, emotional, and life-changing.
There's something for everybody, and your marriage is going to be better when you're done.
Don't miss the opportunity to do something great for your marriage today.
Everyone's welcome, no matter where you are, what you've done. It's a great program and highly recommend it.
Yeah, I would say no matter where you are in your marriage, this can be a game changer, literally a life changer for your marriage in the future. So it's an awesome experience.
So most of you know that Cheryl and I
came to Re-Engage because
Re-Engage was very important to Cheryl and I. And some of you may not know, Cheryl had breast cancer and she passed away back in February. And this is just something that was just so crucial to our marriage. You know, we had a real good marriage going into it. And, you know, when the program first came up, we're like, yeah, we'll do it. You know, we thought we'd be okay with it, you know, and we were doing good. But I realized, you know, one of the things they ask you when you go in there, they ask you, rate your marriage, right? So, yeah, we're like, oh, we're probably like a, I don't know, an 8, you know. And you find out, like, within the first 2 weeks, you're probably more like a 5. And, but we used that, but we knew that that was just a very special thing. Within a couple of weeks, we knew that. And we knew that was something we wanted to keep on doing. And when we started that, that was before Cheryl had her diagnosis with cancer. And then we went, finished that first semester, and it was great. We learned a lot there. And we learned enough to know that we needed to go back. And not only just go back, is we wanted to go back and be leaders and help other marriages. And so we approached the leaders, and we did that. We joined and became leaders. And so we went through the second semester as kind of learning. You know, we were there as a couple, but we were there to learn also. That's when we got her cancer diagnosis. And it was then when I really knew that Re-Engage was something I needed, because of all the challenges we had that came up through that. And it was just a really helpful thing to get me through. And obviously, you know, Cheryl battled that for 4 years. And so we went through Re-Engage every single semester. So we've been through it 8 times probably. And so it's just a real special time. You learn things there the other thing I tell people is you're going to learn things in Re-Engage that you can apply to your marriage, but there's also a lot of things you're going to get out of Re-Engage that you can apply in everyday life. And even now today, I still apply the things that I learned in Re-Engage and the things I do at work, when I talk to friends or whatever. So it's a really, really good thing. So just a couple of points on here. If you're considering it, please come see me. I'd love to talk to you about it. Childcare is provided, so you don't have to worry about childcare. It'd be a great date night. You know, you have somebody watch the kids, you have a babysitter automatically for you. One thing to clarify, they talked about 16 weeks. So Re-Engage has gone through a reformat, so now it's 14 weeks. And then at the end of that 14 weeks, you're going to have a celebration dinner. And so that's just a really nice, special catered event that you come. You'll have a nice meal as a group. And it's just a really special time. On August 13th, there is what they call an open group. So this is an opportunity, if you're kind of on the fence, you're not sure if this is for you or not, come on out. It's at State Road 16 at 6 o'clock. And you can kind of see a little bit about what it's about. They'll have a nice testimony for you, and then they'll have a big group where you just kind of talk a little bit about a few things. Nothing real major. After that large group, then what you do is you'll get broken out into smaller groups, and we only look at 4 or 5 couples in each group. And the reason for that is we want that small group, that small you know, where you can build that circle of trust. And once that small group is created, no one else will ever come into that group. So it's a really safe place to talk and things like that. And I can tell you, I've seen marriages change. And that is an incredible thing as a leader. And you go into a group like that and you see a marriage that's struggling, and you know through your word that you've, you know, just touched that family and that group. And it's just an amazing thing. I mean, it just brings chills to me when I talk about that. It's just an incredible experience. The other thing is the cost of Re-Engage. It is $60. One thing that Cheryl, that I did, and because, again, how deep it meant to Cheryl and I, we do have a few scholarships that we've created So if the $60 is a struggle for you, come see us. We do have some financial assistance for that. So because we really feel strongly about this, that, you know, we'd like to get our couples involved in this. Did I talk about 14 weeks? I can't remember. Okay, I did. All right, well, that's kind of all I had on Reengage again. I just want to take a moment, and I want to pray for the marriages in the room here today. And one key thing that I'll leave you with this. The number one thing you can do to impact your marriage, in my opinion, is invite God into your marriage. Put Christ in the middle, and that will solve a lot of issues. So as I do say a prayer for the married couples, I encourage the married couples, if you haven't done it, or if you've done it a long time ago, while I pray, pray for God to enter into your marriage. Lord, we just thank you for marriages. We thank you for bringing together couples. And Lord, we know there's a lot of struggle that can kind of come up during marriages. But we also know that if we put you in the center, Lord, that and we both couples, you know, look to focus the guy to be more Christ-like, that you're going to pull us together as couples and create a solid bond there. Lord, I just pray for all the couples in this room, wherever they're at, if they if this speaks to them and you guide them into this, that they follow your lead to this ministry. This is a wonderful opportunity. Lord, I just give it all to you, Lord, and just bless all the marriages in this room. Amen.
So this next song is called Blessed Be the Name. It really means a lot to me because as a child, I always played in worship band with my family, and this is one that I actually did at a talent show in elementary school. And it was just incredible because it talks about how we can glorify God, whether it is through a marriage or just anything you're doing, you can glorify Him through it. And I just think it's incredible that we can talk about it in a song while glorifying Him.
Blessed be your name in a land that is plentiful, with streams of abundance flow. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name when I'm found in the desert place, though I walk through the wilderness. Blessed be your name. Every blessing you pour out, I'll turn back to praise. When the darkness closes in, Lord, still I will say, blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your glorious name. Blessed be your name when the sun's shining down on me, when the world's all as it should be. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name on the road marked with suffering, though there's pain in the offering. Blessed be your name. Every blessing you pour out, I'll turn back to praise. When the darkness closes in, Lord, still I will say, blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your name. Yeah, blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your glorious name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your name. Blessed be of the Lord. Blessed be your glorious name. You give and take away. You give and take away. My heart will choose to say, Lord, blessed be your name. You give and take away. You give and take away. You give and take away. My heart will choose to say, Lord, blessed be the name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your glorious name. Sing that bridge one more time. You give and take away. You give and take away. My heart will choose to say, Lord, blessed be your name. Amen. I love that. Your heartbeat trouble, hold your head up. I don't fear no evil. Fix your eyes on this one truth. God is madly in love with you. Take courage, hold on, be strong. Remember where our help comes from. Our redemption. Jesus, our redemption, our salvation is in his blood. Jesus, light of heaven, reign forever, his kingdom. So don't let your heart be troubled. Hold your head up high. Don't fear no evil. Fix your eyes on this one truth. God is madly in love with you. Take courage, hold on, be strong. Remember where our help comes from. Let the praise go up as the walls come down. All creation, everything with breath, repeat the sound. All His children, clean hands, pure hearts, good grace, good God. His name is Jesus. Swing wide, all you heavens. Let the praise go up as the walls come down. All creation, everything with breath, repeat the sound. All His children, clean hands, pure hearts, good grace, good God. His name is Jesus. So swing wide, all you heavens. Let the praise go up as the walls come down. All creation, everything with breath, repeat the sound. All His children, clean and pure hearts, good grace, good God. His name is Jesus. Sing with me one more time. So swing wide, all you heavens. Let the praise go up as the walls come down. All creation, everything with breath, repeat the sound. All His children, clean and pure hearts, good grace, good God. His name is Jesus. And oh, 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 oh. And oh, oh, oh. Don't let your heart be troubled. Don't let your heart be troubled. Hold your head up high. Don't fear no evil. Fix your eyes on this one truth. God is madly in love with you. So take courage, hold on, be strong. Remember where I have come from. And oh, 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 and oh, 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 oh.
Jesus, our redemption.
Jesus, our redemption, our salvation is in His blood.
Just our voices.
Jesus, light of heaven, friend forever, His kingdom come.
Amen.
Beautiful. Now we're in this point of our service for our tithes and offering. We have a tithe box in the back if you're here, or you can also give online. That's the way I do it. It's really easy. You can text 904-441-6701. There's kind of a theme there, isn't there? text ACEGIVE to that number, and I'll get you to the push pay, and it's really simple there. You just follow the directions there. It's a good way of doing it. ACE Kids, we're out to the side door to go to your class. So let's pray. Lord, we just, you give us so much in everything we do, and this is a time where we can give back to you to further your work in our community and around the world. And Lord, we just, this is a very special time. We just want to give you all we can, in whether it be our service, whether it be our tithing. Lord, we just ask you just to use this to further your work. Amen.
Good morning, church. Ever felt lightheaded before you're supposed to do something really important? Had a banana, had a cinnamon pastry, so feeling a little better. But want to just have a brief conversation with you about something. You know, when it comes to knowing Jesus and to trusting him in every aspect of our lives, I think there's one area that many people, I don't know if they avoid it, they try to just ignore it. Some of them really have battles about it. But it's generosity. It's a place of giving yourself away. And I think in our world today, especially in our country, so much revolves around stuff, money, things, and for me, I've always tried to make sure that that's something that wasn't going to be a problem for me, you know, that wasn't going to have a hold on me. And then when we come to Anastasia Church Elkton, we plant a church out in an area that, compared to our church as a whole, financially is, it's a struggle. You know, it's a challenge. It's a place of uncertainty. And so this morning, I just want to briefly talk about how we can, as a believer, but also as a someone that trusts Jesus. I mean, someone that honestly says, "God, man, I don't know how this bank account's going to work this week. I don't know how I'm going to pay for that bill. I don't know how we're going to be able to go forward next month or next year." I think this morning, because this is a closing out of a series that we're calling Declaration of Dependence, not Independence, that we're looking at the Declaration of Dependence on generosity. And for us to really see how that challenges us. And this is from 2 Corinthians chapter 8, verses 1 through 5. And so let's look at that. If y'all want to stand in the honor of God's word. It says, "We want you to know, brothers, about the grace of God that has been given among the churches of Macedonia. For in a severe test of affliction, their abundance of joy and their extreme poverty have overflowed in a wealth of generosity on their part. For they gave according to their means, as I can testify, and beyond their means, of their own accord, begging us earnestly for the favor of taking part in the relief of the saints. And this, not as we expected, but they gave themselves first to the Lord and then by the will of God to us." Let's pray. That's our heart's cry right now, Lord God, that we give ourselves first to you, Lord, and then by your will to us, that you would increase and that we would decrease. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So I'm going to give you 2 points this morning. I had more, but I'm going to just boil it down to two, because I think it really has in that last verse what I just prayed in that prayer, which is that we first give ourselves to the Lord and then to the will of God in us. That we declare our dependence on God when generosity begins with faith in God's trust fund. That unless we take that first step, the Holy Spirit is not there to move in us to do things that we would never choose to do ourselves. To take a step of faith, especially something so life-revolving that we've been taught through everything in our world around us, that our time, our talents, and our treasures, but that fortune, that finance, that generosity begins with faith in God's trust fund, because it says they gave themselves first to the Lord. 2 Corinthians 8:9 says, "For you know the grace of our Lord Jesus, that though he was rich, yet for the sake he came poor, so that by his poverty we might become rich." Wow. That's God's trust fund to us. That he had everything, and he gave it all up to become one of us, so that then we might be rich. He gave it all. Colossians 2:13 and 14 says, "And you, who were dead in your trespasses and in the uncircumcision of your flesh, God made alive together with him, having forgiven us all our trespasses, by canceling the record of debt that stood against us with its legal demands. This he set aside, nailing it to the cross." Wow. Canceling the debt that stood against us with its legal demands. Our sin separates us from God. And that is a penalty. That's a debt that we could never pay. But God gives us that by nailing himself to the cross. That paid that price completely. That should... that should bring you to a place of awe. That we can never pay that back. That we could never get to a place of, I mean, even paying up a small portion of it. It's so great. It's so full, so overflowing. And that when we come to a place of going, wow, God's given me a trust fund, that in his death, he's providing for me over and over for my past, for my present, and for my future. And then that takes me to a place when I declare my dependence on God. When I realize that generosity is also from beggars that can be choosers. You've heard of that phrase before, right? Beggars can't be choosers. According to these verses, beggars can be choosers. Look at this, 2 Corinthians 8:3 and 4. "For they gave according to their means, as I can testify, and beyond their means of their own accord, begging us earnestly for the favor of taking part in the relief of the saints." Begging us earnestly for the favor of taking part in the relief of the saints. Are we begging God for his favor? For us, first and foremost, but then for each other? Because what he's given us, he then wants us to share with each other. Every aspect of our life. Romans 5:8 says, "For God shows his love for us, and that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us." Can I put that a little different? While we were completely broke, Christ paid off all the penalties to all my bankruptcies. Did you get that? While we were completely broke, Christ paid off all the penalties to all my bankruptcies. Paid in full. And he loves us. Unconditionally. So as we close this generosity that he's given us, it spurs us on to be generous with one another. Thank you, church, for your love. Thank you for loving each other, and thank you for giving for a community that has, in the last 6 years, said, we believe in a God that is generous. And although we might not have a lot, this widow has a couple mites that we're going to bring together. And those $115,000, $116,000 that's been collected is an investment in generosity. To say we believe in a trust fund that God has given us not only for heaven, but for his kingdom to come on earth as it is in heaven. And so with his timing and for his glory, thank you for being generous. And we look forward to what that means to this point on. I'm going to ask Chad to come up and pray for us. We do have a few things that we have to do today in putting things away. Now that everything's got to go back for school. But we want to just have a dependence on it. The generosity that God's given us. Amen.
Before I pray, if you don't mind, I have something that ties right in exactly what he's talking about with trust fund. I've been sharing with you all day about my wife. So there was a time that we were in the middle of her treatment. And there was a medication that they wanted her to have, and the medication was crazy price, expensive, right? And we didn't really have the money for it. And so, that's after the insurance covers what they do, right? You know, and it came down to where we were like, well, do we maybe not tithe this month? Or do we get the medication? And just like Pastor Mason said, you know, we took it to the Lord and we prayed about it. And for those of you who know Cheryl, you would totally get this. She's like, God gots me. We're going to tithe. I'm not going to use that money for the medication. And, you know, as a husband, that was a hard thing to hear, that she has the opportunity to take some cancer medication, but instead she's turned it over to God. And that's where Reengage came in, actually, part of it. It helped me get through that. And so we did it. You know, that's what we did. And we talked about it and everything else, and we did that. So the very next day, we get a phone call. There's just been a grant established that will cover that medication. She can start treatment on Wednesday. Here we are. We were on that verge of making that decision, and we trust to follow God. And God rewarded us for that. And there's been, I can give you lots of examples, you know, through that journey that Cheryl and I went through, where we just chose to follow God. And that'd be my message to everyone is, I know times it gets tough, you know, but follow God in everything. Everything you do, whether it's your marriage or your tithing or whatever it is. So we'll just go ahead and end in prayer a little bit. Sam, as they come up and he can start playing and things like that. And then during this song, I'm going to be down front if you'd like me to pray for you or, you know, talk about marriages or whatever, any of that stuff. I'll be up front ready for you. And so let's go ahead and pray. Lord God, first off, we just thank you for this day, and we thank you for this opportunity to be in this place and worship, Lord. And we just ask you to look over just everyone that is not feeling well. Pastor Mason, he's not feeling well. He's on his way to get some treatment, and hopefully, you know, that that he follows and recovers and is back with us again next week. Lord, we just thank you for the generosity of every person here as they give all they can give, whether it's in their service, it's their talents, playing guitar, which Sam does a great job at. And Lord, we just thank you and give you everything. We ask this in your name. Amen.
How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God? And all will see how great, how great is our God.
Thank you, church. I just want to remind everybody, next week we're going to be at the Leger's house. If you need directions, just get with me and I don't remember her address right off the top of my head, but I'll get it to you. Don't worry about it. Remember bathing suits, because she has a nice pool there. All that good stuff that you need for outside. Don't forget the sunblock. You're going to need plenty of sunblock. And there's going to be hot dogs and things like that. Have a great week, everyone. I'll still be around if anybody wants to come up and talk. Thank you.
The address is on the screen.
Oh, there you go.